Greetings once again, fellow girls, guys, and gaming fans. This is Small Archangel. Welcome back to Someday to Die Alpha 15. We made a pretty good start to our series yesterday by setting ourselves up in this humble abode in the middle of a pine forest, but close, by the look of it, to a maple forest, and we're obviously on the edge of a pathway here as well. I actually searched the joint last night and found a cooking pot. In fact, I found four, and I also found a little bit of coal as well, because now it spawns as loot in containers and things, particularly, I'm assuming, ovens, because that's where I found that, which makes vague sense, I suppose, though a coal-fired oven is a bit rare nowadays. I also upgraded my gear, so what I often do at night is just sort of recraft things. So I've made my clothing, the bits that I needed. We're still wearing a skirt, look at that. I actually look female for once. But they are still not great quality. And I did recraft my club and my bow as well. So we're probably going to have to re-equip my arrows there. And what we're going to do today, we're going to leave everything here. I've actually got quite a bit of stuff there, including a spare cooking pot and I don't know what. And found a little bit of fertilizer as well. So we've got a bit of a stash there, but that's stuff we don't necessarily need because I want to be able to do some looting. And, oh, actually, what I wanted to do was make an... I'm not sure if I want an entrance way down there or if I've destroyed some of the furniture down there, and I'm not sure if we're coming back or not. I think we probably have to think about that depending on whether we're going to come back here or no. We know we're near to the trader station, so we're going to go and find the trader station today because that's what we want to do. And if we're going to come back here, then we'll be able to... just collect some bones and animal fat of these guys now. If we decide we're going to come back to this shed and that's going to be our first base, then we can sort of think how to upgrade it at that point. So we want to follow our path first. Where is it? It's over here. So we're going to follow this path. We're going to see where it goes. See if it goes... obviously, it should lead to the trader station, ultimately, to a road, to other... prefabs and places of interest, and there's a pig. I probably should shoot it, shouldn't I? We probably should. It'd be rude not to. For some reason, he's just standing there. Are you stuck? Well, okay, I missed. How did I miss a pig that's pinned to the ground? That's ridiculous. We already made a shiv. And I'm collecting bones because you can make glue out of them. And duct tape being one of the most useful items in game. And glue can be used to make duct tape. And bones can be used to make glue, therefore. I don't think there's anything in game that's completely useless now. We can even use human turds that we find in toilets. Oh, looks like the weather's turned rainy. There we go. And we'll just karate chop that as well. Oop, hole in the ground randomly. Sure I hit it quite that hard. Okay, how are we doing for resources? Generally, we could probably do with taking down a tree or two because we've done quite a lot of building last night and we might well be doing a bit more. Who knows? We might find somewhere better to call base, but you can call pretty much anything your first base. It doesn't really matter. It doesn't have to be particularly secure, particularly since... with the new horde system, we never have too many zombies to deal with at the same time. That said, they aren't half persistent, and you can kill them, and they will just keep coming. So it is worth bearing that in mind. A stone axe, there we go. So getting some metal and being able to upgrade the outside of whatever you choose as your base is a very good idea, because they do chew through wood. Like it's not there, don't you, madam? Yes. Chew that. Let's see how that tastes. Cornmeal. No, not really a priority right now. Ah, look. There is the kind of place. Well, actually, it's bigger than ours, but I think it's a bit trashed, actually. There's a couple of places. We might be able to loot something from them. Then again, we might not. This one... yeah, they're both kind of burnt out. So these are possibilities for temporary bases also, of course. Yeah, this one's got some zeds around it, hasn't it? I missed him. I was distracted by the mountain view and I missed him. Stay on task. Stay focused or you will die. Oh, yes. Shoot all the zombies first. Oh, shoot them and then loot them. When they're all dead. Just check behind myself and kind of keep hoping that that whole rear stealth spawn business won't happen anymore, but you know, it's safest to assume that it does. Certainly did in the beta. Okay, you guys, none of you have got anything. That's really, really stingy. There we go. He'll probably decompose in a minute anyway, but never mind. There we go. Anyone else? We got you all now. Okay, so we may as well check this place out. It's identical to our own, but heck, I found some decent loot in the one we were in last night, so come on. We got ourselves 6 hide off that pig, so that wasn't too shabby either. There we go. Oh, iron. And oops. Oh, lovely. We'll have that. And some random stuff. We'll put this in our little chest in our temporary base. Nothing. Okay, we're not getting much from that. Cupboard's always worth looting. No, nothing in there. We have got a floating bird's nest. That suggests to me there was a cupboard there. But I don't think there was, to be honest. I don't think there was. For some reason, that bird's nest has just not been played. There, you see, there's more of these, but we don't need any more of them. We've already got a spare one, so we'll scrap that, and we'll head off to the next house, which is a bigger one, but as I say, it looks kind of trashed. The good thing about that is, if it is, we're not going to have too much problem with zombies. We have got our spawns on medium, which is... ooh, painkillers. We want to put those in there. Spare bandages, too. Which is a little bit ambitious. Now, I know Steve's seen me, and I'm not having him kicking my rear end from behind, because that's not allowed. Okay, moving shadows make me jumpy. I always think it's a zombie sneaking up to me. More feathers, more arrows. Need more and more. Eventually, I always end up with silly amounts of feathers and things. But stuff like that now, of course, if you've got excessive amounts of anything, if you make an underground base and end up with more stone than you can possibly imagine, you just sell it. You sell it to the traders. Even stuff like that, because this is nest-tastic, this is great. Even stuff like that can be sold to the traders. So, but right now, of course, we have not got an excessive amount of anything. Alrighty, this is a trashed one, so we're not going to find ever so much here. May as well take this wood here. They can make starter bases, but you do have quite a lot of work to do to get them up to snuff. And one of the things I like about the little shack we have there is it's so small that it's very easy to kind of keep up to, because it's got a small footprint, which is how I like my bases. So you're never too far from... let's check it out. It might have something in. You never know, do you? Yeah, you're never too far from where the zombies are. Now that's just a gift, isn't it? No, he's off. Say he. It's got to be a she, right? Because that's a chicken and they're always female. We got ya. I'm sorry, madam, but you know. We need feathers. We need meat. Oh yeah. Edgar, he's heard me, but I'm sorry, Edgar. I gotta harvest this chicky before it disappears. Woo! Okay. Oh, that was unfair. Yes! Well, so far, and I know I shouldn't say this, because I'll really regret it, but so far, no zombie has actually got a hit in. This is a very good thing, because they punch hard, and we aren't wearing any armor. So, I don't suppose we'll find anything. Oops, not. That's not what I was after. Yeah, I was after some coal. There we go. Don't suppose there'll be anything much in there. Brass takes so long to scrap down, I tend to avoid picking it up. Yeah. Our bottles and jars now scrap in... no, they don't scrap at all. Our jars now stack in really big stacks, which is fantastic. I don't know what a full stack size is. 50 or something, maybe? I'm not sure. Nope, there wasn't any in there. They're good. Tires are good to sell to traders. I've discovered this already. And anything in the toilet? Yeah, murky water. Okay, that saves us from having to find a water source. Because so far, I don't think we have. Not yet, we haven't. No, where are we on the map anyway? Oh, we're quite away from the hub, I think. Hub's going to be this away. And down some. Yeah, we're a long way from the hub. But that's okay. We're not exactly wanting to go for the... See, look at those light rays. Just everything just looks so nice now. I might just pick up that candle. We could use that back at base. And there is nothing else here. There is a campfire, but it's got nothing in it. Okay, we could probably trash stuff like that, for example. But I'm not sure how much use there actually is in it. We do need metal, so I don't know what we'll get for this. Not a lot, probably. 6. You see, that's a bit rubbish, really. Not sure it was really worthwhile. Probably do better things with our time. Like... kill that zombie. And follow this path. Yes! One shot it. Do we have... Yeah, we smell. We've got meat, so we're going to be attracting the whole way, but I don't care. As long as we can get our shot in first, we're good. We're fine. He who shoots first wins. And that can apply to the zombies as well, so we have to take a little bit of care there. How are we doing? We have stones. We're a little bit short on stones, so actually we will just take one of these. Actually, we might take a couple of them. Just make sure there's no... There's a zombie over there, but she's quite a way off, so I'm not too worried about her. There's another pig. Maybe we should take him on as well. That way we'll have a decent amount of meat on us. I mean, in for a penny, we've got... Oh, look, there's a trader station. Ace. In for a penny, because quite honestly, we've already got a load of... Oh, okay, we've run out of stamina and Steve's just over there as well. And a blooming pig and a crawler. Okay. The pig has led us towards... Oh, we can't pick that up. How rubbish is that? Let's just scrap those. And I probably don't need that. There we go. That means we've got a full stack already. Oh, he nearly got me. That was careless. Nails. I'm not quite sure why I picked those up. Oh, he's here. Let's get him with a club. I'm not sure where the pig is at this point, but it is not worth taking on a pig when you've got a load of zombies, or even just 2 zombies chasing you. Because while you're trying to loot the piggy's remains, there he is. Yeah, you just find that they're aggroing on you. I want to try destroying those tires as well to see if we get something from that. Yay, we got him. There's the road. Oi, oi, oi. Oh, he must have bled out. Jolly good. Poor piggy, but it's all for a good cause. Well, I think it's a good cause anyway. I think I'm a good cause. My hunger bar is going down, of course. Alright, and then we'll head for the trader. Because we still haven't got that skill point. Oh, hello. You guarding this trader place. I'm sure they'll be delighted. Oh! Oh! I think my arrow just hit the trader station. Oh, damn it, come on. There we are. Finally. Oh, nice! Unfortunately, we can't pick that up. Oh, we must have some random sand. There we go. We don't want random sand, and I will scrap the nails. Nails, definitely another thing that has a use of the game, but not so much. Look at that. That's pretty amazing. From here, the road looks a little bit buggy, but it looks pretty nice, actually. Oh, look. Journey settlement, locate trader. Achieved. Here we go. I'm not quite sure where the path is there. It's kind of just behind me, so. And I'm not sure where the front is. This is the open sign, so I'm guessing There we go, Traitor Joel's full no money back guarantee. Epic. Okay, so hopefully it should be fairly easy now to be able to find our way to a trader station each and every time. Oh look, corn. Can I actually nab that? I've actually got a stack of that already, so that's awesome. Let's do it. I'm sorry guys, but I'm stealing your stuff. Okay, I can't. Okay. That's cool. These vending machines, well no, not those vending machines. They're the ones that if you've got a few dupes, they're pretty useful. But these vending machines, the rental ones, apparently NPCs will buy your stuff off these as well. So I might have to try that at some point when I've actually got something to sell. Right now we have not got anything much to sell. Did I shut the gate behind me? This is the question. Yeah, either that or it shut itself. They do shut themselves sometimes. Okay, let's just check this out. This is the first time I've found a trader station with this kind of model. I've seen different variants. I've not seen this one, so let's just have a little look. Yeah, you can see how this would be an exploit if they didn't automatically turf you out at night. Get in here and find our way around a little bit. We can't destroy any of this stuff. We can't add to it either. We certainly can't put a respawn point in here. That would be cheating. But I am liking these stainless steel pieces here. I've actually used them in a couple of my creative builds. I don't know if we can... Oh, look. We can use that. We could perhaps use a cement mixer from in here if we didn't have one ourselves. And I'm pretty sure, actually, that we couldn't... We can't take it with us. We're not going to be able to take it with us. Right. We're not going to be able to take anything apart in here, are we? Alrighty. Who are you? Trader Wrecked. Okay, Trader Wrecked. What do you got?
Well, if you got money, I guess I can stand your smell.
Thank you, Trader Wrecked. That's very nice of you. That would be the raw meat, then. I've got three dukes. I don't think he really can, you know, sort of... And with the old cash, can we buy anything with old cash? Does that actually count for anything? I think everything's just dukes, really. I'm not sure if the old cash... Sell. Ah, used to be legal. A value can be made out of... So we can sell old cash. And we can sell it for... for 16 dukes. Well, we may as well, since we've got nothing else to sell it for. Let's just see how much we can sell that for. Nothing. It has no selling price. There's a surprise. We can't sell absolutely everything. Gunpowder, no sell price. Okay, we can't sell gunpowder. Coal, we can sell. I think probably most things we can sell. Let's see. What among everything we've got has got a decent sale price? Yeah, drugs have got a good sale price. No, that would be pointless, wouldn't it? The sale price on drugs is pretty good. Glue, not bad. Wood, 5 per 50, so that's pretty charred, really. Iron. I think...
Don't let the door hit you on your way out.
Yeah, that would be terrible, wouldn't it? I think if we can find a popping pills or something, we could probably pretty much, you know, we could clean up if we could... sell the contents to Trader Wrecked or Trader anybody else for that matter. But there's five of these trade stations around. Oh look, there's a water source. So now we kind of have everything we need apart from a POI. So I'm just gonna take some nourishment. Ah, now speaking of nourishment, here we're in a desert or plains or something. No, this is plains rather than desert, but we can subsist on some of these. The yucca fruit that we get from cacti. Ouch, damn it. That is always a downside. And so I'm going to gather a fair few of these as well. Also, if I gather them, that means I won't, you know, sort of injure myself on them as well. So that's a double bonus. And then we've got an emergency food source. And we can see the road goes up that way, which looks kind of deserty. But I like the idea of settling somewhere near to... Oh, that's trash now. We'll make a new one. I like the idea of settling somewhere near to a bunch of different biomes, because that way we can really get all of the resources that we need, including mining for shale gas and all the rest of it, shale oil. And yeah, that is the maple biome just over there, and there's a crawler headed straight for me. In fact, there's several zombies all converging on me now. Is it because I smell? Trader Rex said I smell. Do you agree? Not as much as you. Okay, let's take them on one at once. Bye bye. Oh, duct tape. Damn it, I could do with that probably. Oh, that was rubbish. This is why I use a club for these guys. Still have to keep away from their punching hands. Oh, nice. We will have those on our feet. We'll scrap that. See, I quite like oil too, really. I will just scrap that. And I will take the oil. It's a good thing to have for making repair kits from, as is duct tape. So, what else can I feasibly get shot of? Not a lot, to be honest. Not a great deal. I don't really want to get rid of anything. Lead, yeah, that's not actually that useful at this point, so we'll get shot of that. Okay, let's just do away with him. And, oh, sports bag. We can't really pick anything much else up at this point. Ah, look. Now, if they were a decent quality, I'd sell them or keep them myself. But at the moment, we're a little bit short on capacity. So I will just... Oh gosh, I thought they were a load of zombies. A load more cacti. Quite like to collect some more cacti. But I also want to get some water in some of these water jars. And our murky water actually collects quite as well as empty jars, which means we will actually have a spare space in our inventory there as well, in case we find anything else worth scavenging. Right, so we'll have 24 jars of water now. We'll do that. There we go. We've got some stones and some rocks. We'll just grab some of that. But we're going to have to head back to base before too much longer. We haven't found ourselves a town, but there's probably one round here soon, somewhere close by, not too far away. Because, generally speaking, my experience of Alpha 15, the betas at least, was that there were quite a lot of towns around, actually. So it wasn't such a struggle to find one as it felt like it was in Alpha 14. Oh, it's a rabbit. Not gonna worry about chasing after a rabbit. Okay, I'm not gonna hit that because we don't need gas right now. And I'll get gas rather than metal from that if I hit it with my axe. Got a very interesting pattern on the side of that hill there, and that looks like wasteland. And then the road goes off in that direction as well. It looks very flat over there, so it may possibly be a POI. But before we head back to base, I am going to go and just check out that pattern there, just in case that is some sort of ore. Because obviously iron ore would be really very useful indeed. But it kind of looks checkered, so I'm not sure what it is. Is that a shed? That's the shed we looked at before, I think. So that's the path we need to follow to go back to base. Oopsie. Ta! You see? I didn't want to pick up that sand. Oh, did I not? I picked up the lead again. How did that happen? Hey, they're actually not a bad quality as well. So we'll sell those, because at the moment there's not a lot of point in saving up for a mini bike. Yeah, that's probably sand or something. Yeah, that's nothing exciting, is it? Okay, we are wet. Nice. So now we have to get back out of here, which is not so easy. We're probably gonna... I can't get out of there. I'm probably going to lose the can if I drop that, and I'd really like to be able to scrap it, so... You see, that repeated jumping noise gets on my nerves, actually. That is something I think needs addressing. So I will switch that over, and we can have yucca to hand, and those we can just happily munch on as we run back to base. And I think we have... That's our trader station there. So I'm going to put Trader. I'm going to put that on there just to keep that marked up for our reference. We've got a couple of other sheds, but I actually do prefer the one we already have. So that's kind of nice. I think we will stay there for the moment. We have done a little bit of work on the place, and we will be able to do more. And having found it on day one as well, that's pretty cool. I don't want to go to the trader station to sell these wheels now because I'm worried we won't get home in time. And I would quite like to get back to base in time to be able to, you know, not worry too much about things and to be able to perhaps, you know, boil myself an egg or something and make some fresh water out of the jars of water that we just collected. I've got 13 jars of water, so we're not doing too shabbily there at all. So we're continuing our good work. That we do seem to be surrounded by great big mountains of... Oh, I'm cold. Great big mountains of wasteland, which isn't so good. But that's... Yeah, that is actually plains. By the look of that, that is actually plains. But from where I'm standing, it looks like wasteland. So I'm not too sure, really. We'll have to check that out and see, because it can be difficult to tell distant textures. Let's just... hop it across. I've got kind of into the habit of following roads more than anything else, simply because if you don't follow roads in the wastelands, you get blown up. You fall across, you know, fall over mines and blow yourself up and things. So it kind of has conditioned me, I suppose, into following the roads a little bit more. That said, it's not necessary to worry about that in a pine forest. Alright, is this our shack here? We're going to have to do a little bit of work to the place to... Yes, puff pad, but you're nearly there now, girl. Keep going. We're going to have to do a little bit of work to the place to make it secure for the first 7-day horde, but we're going to be able to do that without too much trouble, I think. I think I will just put a door on here. We know that doors are asking for trouble with regards to... Oh yeah, of course. How silly of me. Let me just trash that. Oh, I won't trash that because I can't pick up anything from there just now if I do that. Let's just put away a load of this stuff. Okay, and then we'll go back down and finish what we started. There we go. There we are. Lovely. And I will probably just get rid of all this as well. Because there's no point in having furniture down here because the zombies will just destroy it. There we are. Let's upgrade that. Lovely. Yep, and we can do that also. So we'll take this lot out. We'll get some metal from that. And we're going to have to upgrade the interior of our base here as well. These won't respawn anyway. If we're using this as a base, they will not respawn in any case. Sinks, I think we get a little bit of metal from as well. There we go. And we can harvest the tap, which I think will just give us a tap. Yeah, randomly. But we can scrap it for brass as well. So, there we go. And we're going to need some... we might as well take that too. There we go, it's night time. Probably not a great idea to be battering away things at night time, to be honest. There we go. And yeah, we're probably going to have to... We're going to have to do some reinforcing around the place as well, because it's not particularly secure at the moment. I will just do that. I'm not convinced that the zombies can punch upwards when they are... Oh, look, we can put some more coal in there. Yeah, they might not be able to punch upwards if they climb up your ladder. I'm not sure, but... Okay, I'm going to put this in some semblance of order. We've got a candle there, which I will place somewhere. I want my food at the top, really. This is how I normally do things. Okay, there we go. That's kind of organized. And then I guess we probably want to put this candle somewhere so that we can... We've got a little bit better visibility around here. Yeah, that's not quite where I meant it to go, was it? And it might be a little bit difficult to place it correctly. Yeah, there we go. That's what I meant. And how do we make others? We probably need tallow, right? We need tallow. So we've got some animal fat in here. And we'll put that in the cube on the fire. Okay, that's going to take a little while. It'll probably take all night, but I don't think we'll get any screamers just yet. I haven't yet seen a screamer in Alpha 14. 15, I beg your pardon. And we'll make some more frames too. Wood frames, let's just favourite them. And we'll make a bunch of those. Let's see. We'll make 10 more, because we're going to do this place up a little bit more. And we're going to make another entrance, really. What we want to do is to not have that door down there as our main entrance. Yes, we can get in there, but so can the Zeds, and they will be attracted to that door. So we actually want our entrance to be somewhere else. So I think at this point what we might do is make use of... Oh, actually, maybe not that. Maybe we'll have the ones with the railing. There we go. I don't know, actually. No, let's have the ones without the railing. I don't know how many we'll need. Because that way we're going to be better able to shoot off the side of them if we need to. How are we doing here? Oh, we've got lots of water. This is good. And still going with the water. So I'll put our water. Not that one. This one here. In there. And then we've got our catwalks here. Now these might be a little bit difficult to place. I really want to position them dead centre here. Is that centre? I think that's central. There we go. The trouble is I'm going to want to place one there. And it probably won't want to place while I'm standing anywhere near it. No, it won't. And I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to reach that from the ground. Ah, can I reach that from over there? There we are. And that's basically what we want to do, is have these go across to the other side. Because if we do that, then we can make this. I can't see. It's too dark. But we can make this our entrance. Right here. Okay, we're going to have some work to do that, of course. So again, I shall make a door to go on there. We don't need to do this all, you know, overnight. So we don't need to worry about it too much at this point. There we are. And I'll upgrade that too. And that not being on the first floor, we don't need to worry too much. The Zeds can't get to it. And I think what we'll do is we'll enclose this off so the zombies can't actually get to it. And I'm going to make some torches. Torch. Okay, we need... fragments of cloth, which I don't think we've got on us, and wood. Right, there we go. Lovely. And that will do for now. And I will put those torches around the place downstairs so that we can see what we're doing down there as well. And then, yeah, this place is starting to get good. So, things still to do then. First episode styly, what we really look at this really thin narrow biome of maple. That's kind of disappointing. Bit more exploring. We need to find a POI really. If we can find ourselves a town, then we've got ourselves a good looting base. I think that's not done. No, it's not done yet. We've got ourselves a good looting base, and that's what we really want, is to find somewhere where we can go find some stores, get the resources that we're going to need for more advanced gameplay. In the meantime, we're going to do this place up so that it's going to save us from the day 7 horde, which will come round all too quickly, as usual. In the meantime, I guess we should call this an episode because it's already 2 a.m. on day 3. So I do hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, you know what to do. Let me know. Leave any comments as well. Think about subscribing if you haven't already. Check out what else is on the channel. And I hope you'll join me for the next episode of 7 Days to Die Alpha 15. Until then, keep gaming, keep surviving, stay happy. Bye-bye for now.